Greetings and welcome to another Math is Everywhere video. Today, our topic in Unit 5 is our last topic in Unit 5. I know you're going to be sad, but we've got to finish it sometime. And today we're talking about y equals mx plus b, which is an equation that we call slope-intercept form. That might not make much sense to you right now, but it will. So, here we go. Let's review the idea of slope. Hopefully at this point we should be pretty familiar with it. Remember that the letter m is used to represent the slope of the line, and we don't know why the letter m is the letter of choice, but it just is, so we go with it. We also remember that the slope of a line is a ratio. It's something over something. And that something over something is the vertical change of a line over the horizontal change of a line, or what we called the rise over the run. Or we also said it's like the up-down change versus the left-right change. Or we even said that it's the change in the y value over the change in the x value. Or we even made a little equation out of that, a formula, where we did the y2 minus y1, x2 minus x1, basically the second y minus the first y over the second x minus the first x. That's just a review, but the idea here is there's a lot of ways to find the slope of a line. All right, we got a new concept though, and this new concept is the idea of a y-intercept, and every line has one. Well, just about every line has one. So, a y-intercept is just a fancy name for where a line intersects the y-axis. We all know what the y-axis is, okay? And every line just about is going to cross the y-axis somewhere. So if you look at this line, you can see it crosses the y-axis right there. That's the y-intercept of this line, and we give it a number. This line has a y-intercept of 1 because it crosses the y-axis at 1. Notice, it's not at 0, it's not at 2, it's right in between them. The y-intercept of this line is at 1. Let's take a look at a few more just to make sure we got it. This one in the upper left has a y-intercept of 3 because that's where it crosses the y-axis. This one down here in the lower left has a y-intercept of negative 1. Yep, a y-intercept can be negative because a line can cross that y-axis on the bottom half too. This one has a y-intercept of 0 because it goes right through the origin. This is the only kind of a line that doesn't have a y-intercept. If it's vertical, it might not go through the y-axis at all. And that's okay. But now we know what a y-intercept is. Okay, let's go back to what we were doing earlier in this unit, taking an equation and using an equation to find some points by making kind of a table. This table looks a little different than the kind of tables that you are using, but the idea is we're going to plug negative 1 in for x, and then we're going to do 4 times negative 1, which is negative 4, and then we're going to add 1, which bumps it down to negative 3. Now we're going to plug in 0. 4 times 0 is 0. Plus 1 is 1. Then we'll plug in 1. What's 1 times 4? 4. And then you add 1 and you get 5. So we can have 3 points here with x's and y's to make coordinates. Remember how we were making coordinates out of an equation? Yeah, we can do that. So that equation gave us those 3 points. Negative 1, negative 3. 0, 1. And 1, 5. If I'm going too fast for you, feel free to just pause the video and kind of rewind a little bit. Make sure that you understand why those dots are where they are. And make sure you understand that those 3 dots came from the equation y equals 4x plus 1. And now let's connect the dots. And I want to ask you a couple questions about this line. First of all, what's the y-intercept of this line? The y-intercept is right there. The y-intercept is 1. Kind of interesting, that equation had a 1 in it. Probably just a coincidence, though. Okay, what about the slope? What's the slope of this line? Oh, man, we got to count it out. But we can do that. if you count from one dot to another, it goes up 1, 2, 3, 4, and then over 1. The slope is 4. Oh, there's also a 4 in the equation. There's a 4 and the 1. That's probably not a coincidence, is it? No, it's not. And this is what we call slope-intercept form, or a slope-intercept equation. When an equation is written in the form y equals mx plus b, whatever the number is in that m spot is going to tell you the slope of the line, and whatever the number is in the b spot is going to be the y-intercept of the line. And that's really convenient because then you can just look at an equation and tell really quickly what the slope and the y-intercept are, and you don't have to make a big table to find out what the line looks like. So here's an example. If you had y equals 2/3 x plus 5, the slope is 2/3 and the y-intercept is 5. They're right there staring you in the face. So y equals mx plus b is a really helpful and good format for our linear equations. Okay, you can then use that idea to help graph a line really easily and quickly. First of all, what's the slope of this line? It's 1/4, because it's the number right in front of the x. It's the m part of the mx plus b. Then what's the y-intercept of the line? Pretty easy to see. It's a 1. Okay, you just take the 1/4 and the 1. You know that gives you the slope and the y-intercept of the line. And now we can use those numbers to help us graph this line. How are those numbers going to help us graph this line? Well, we know the y-intercept is 1. So we know that the line is going to cross the y-axis at 1. Now, we don't know where that line is going to go from there, or how it's going to cross that line, or what it's going to look like, but we know it crosses right there. That's where slope comes in. From that point, we can count the slope. It's 1/4, so we're going to go up 1/4. Put another dot, and guess what? Now we've got a linear graph. And all we had to do was use the m and the b for our mx plus b. Didn't have to make a table or anything. Wasn't that nice? Let's try another one just for practice. Remember, the form is y equals mx plus b. The m is going to tell you the slope, and the b is going to tell you the y-intercept. So the slope of this line is -3. I'm going to say it's -3/1. Why do I do that? Because slope is supposed to be a ratio, right? Rise and run. What's the y-intercept? 4. Pretty easy. So I'm going to start at 4, put a dot. I'm going to count the slope, which is -3, so -3/1. Put a dot, and there we have our line. Pretty easy, right? Okay, feel free to pause that, rewind it, make sure you're counting out the slope, and make sure it all makes sense. But the beauty of slope-intercept equations is the slope is right there, the intercept is right there, and once you know those two things, you can turn an equation into a graph really quick. Speaking of turning an equation into a graph, it's your turn. Your first practice problem is y equals 2/3 x plus 1. Draw a graph and graph that line. All right. Sometimes we want to work backwards. Instead of turning an equation into a line, I want to take a line and find the equation that goes to it. All I have to do is figure out what the slope of this line is, and then figure out the y-intercept. What's the slope? Count it out. Up 3/1. The slope is 3/1, which is 3. Sweet. What about the y-intercept? That's actually the easiest thing, right? It crosses the y-axis at -5. And therefore, the equation for this line is y equals 3x minus 5, because the slope is 3 and the y-intercept is -5. So, now that you know how to do that, give me an equation for this line. Find the slope, count it out. Find the y-intercept. Where does it cross the y-axis? And once you know those two things, plug the y-intercept in for b, plug the slope in for m, and you'll have yourself a nice linear equation. keep in mind on this one that it's going downhill. That might give you a hint about what the slope should look like. All right, that's it for today. Hope you appreciate the beauty of y equals mx plus b. I know I do.